Happy New Year! Yeah, that's right, I'm talking about this now, because if you know me, I like to stay ahead of the curve. That's not true. So looking back on 2012, I did a lot of stuff, but today I want to focus on my Cambodia trip. Cambodia was amazing. I saw so many temples that I felt like I should be searching for an idol with the aid of a small Asian kid named Short Round. But the biggest thing that we did on this trip was getting scuba certified. I've been dreaming about diving for a long time. I mean, ever since I was a tiny person with a big head and I saw that PBS special of Jacques Cousteau exploring that glorious underwater world, I knew that I wanted to do that. I wanted to have that Jacques Cousteau moment. I want to give a starfish a high five. It just seems so cool. So, thanks to the dive shop, my wife and I embark on a 3-day diving adventure. First day, we get right into it. We get our gear on, we hop on a boat, we find a shallow cove, you know, and then we jump in the water.
The adventure begins!
But, like all good stories and all good adventures, there has to be a villain. And in this adventure, the villain was fear. Now, I don't know what happened, but as soon as I hit the water, something inside me clicked, and I thought about how dangerous this whole thing could be, and I gave way to fear. What horrible timing! But, like any normal man, I just ignored that fear and continued with the lesson. Now, the first order of business was to get used to breathing through our regulators. So we dropped down to our knees in the shallow water, and I start breathing through the regulator. And breathing, and breathing, and I realized I can't catch my breath. And then, fear spoke to me, and he was like, "You are going to be several meters down, with this heavy gear on, and this little mouthpiece that can pop out of your mouth at any moment, causing you to epically drown, like Sonic the Hedgehog." At that moment, I freaked out. So I like stood up, and I like took the regulator out of my mouth, and I was like, and so I realized that I actually had a legitimate panic attack. I couldn't believe it. Never happened to me, ever before. I just let fear get the better of me. So I did what any normal thinking man would do. I took that fear and I pushed it down with the plunger of logic. I was like, "Mark, listen, you're not gonna drown out here, okay? The instructor's right there. If anything bad did happen, okay, he would rescue you, like Superman. Or, well, we're in the water, so like Aquaman." Oh wait, Aquaman's kinda lame. I guess if you're in the water, it's good to... No, he's still lame. Submariner. There you go, Submariner. So my instructor, Martin, assured me that this is all normal and that all I had to do was follow the first rule of diving, which was to breathe slowly and continuously. So I went back under and did just that, and you know, the rest of the day went off without a hitch. So the next day comes along, and that morning was our physical test, which was to swim for 200 meters and then float for 10 minutes. Sounds easy, right? Well, it would be, but I haven't swam for the past 2 years. To make matters worse, we couldn't grab breakfast because it was too early in the morning and no stores or restaurants were open. And to make matters worser than worse, okay, the ocean was like ice cold and super choppy. But hey, I figure I can float for 10 minutes. I just gotta get through the swimming part. So I start, and sure enough, about 20 meters in, I just gas out. No breakfast, no energy. So I had to swim the whole thing on my back, like this, because it was just easier. Oh gosh, it was so freaking awkward. I looked like a homeschooled squid just swimming along. But I got through it. And you know what the best part was? No fear. Now, I thought that after this, I would be able to take a break. But Martin moves right along with the lesson. So we go right to the floating. So there I am, cold, hungry, exhausted, trying to stay afloat while these waves just keep splashing in my face, and I'm thinking to myself, this is my nightmare. Now, admittedly, I lost it a bit there. I felt like fear caught up to me. Fortunately, we reached the 10-minute limit, and I was like, whew, thank God that's over. Let's get some breakfast. But again, Martin moved along with the lesson. So he jumps in the water, and he's handing us our snorkels and our flippers. Now let me say this, I've never worn a snorkel and flippers without the heavy scuba gear weighing me down. It's a whole different world. So there I was, trying to listen to Martin's instructions, but these waves are just slaughtering me. I look at my wife, and she's as calm as a cork, just bobbing in the water. Me, I'm like Goofy, just clumsy beyond all comprehension. So after a few minutes of this, fear decided to step in, and he spoke to me. "You're totally gonna die out here." And I have panic attack numero dos. I look at Martin, and I'm just like, I can't. You need to get me out of the water. So he tows me to the back of the boat, and he tells me to just calm down, gather my thoughts, and then continue when I'm ready. So there I am, on the back of the boat, feeling like a complete failure, just sitting around like a wet dog. And I'm watching my wife, you know, and the other student, his name was Joe, they're doing the skills, like, pff, No problem. At that moment, Joe, the other student, comes swimming up to me and he says, "Hey, have you ever swam in a pool before?" And I was like, "Yeah, of course. It's much easier than scuba diving. You've already done that. Just swim like you would in a pool." It's like, you know what? You're right. So I put my flippies back on, I jump in the water, and I execute those skills with flying colors. But fear was still there, lurking in the shadows. Later in the day, we head down to the depths for another confined dive session. We hit the bottom, and I'm okay. We learn some new skills, and I'm okay. But after a while, that fear, for some reason, comes back on me. And he's like, "I've got three words for you. Sonic the Hedgehog." And right there comes panic attack number three. Ha ha! We're not that far down, so I ascend to the surface as quickly as possible, even though I know I probably shouldn't. And sure enough, as soon as my head breaks the surface, Martin's breaks right after. So after a few apologies, you know, we go back down, and I'm just feeling so defeated. I mean, you know, I'm learning all these skills, and I'm passing, but this newfound fear is just, like, plaguing my mind. So I did the only thing that I could do. I prayed, and I was just like, "God, please help me to conquer this fear inside me." And as I said that, I happened to glance over at my wife, and our eyes, like, meet. And then she signs to me, "I love you. I'm praying for you." And it was in that moment that all my fears just... I realized that I was on an adventure with my best friend and that I should be enjoying all this, not freaking out over something that may or may not happen. So a little later, Martin says, "Hey, you know, we're done with our confined diving for today. Let's go for a leisure dive." So we follow him and we go to deeper waters, and that's when I see it. A reef. A real life reef. I saw so many things. Some of my good old friends, the sea urchins. I saw some brain coral. I saw eels, crabs, and just like tons of fish. And then I realized that I'm seeing things that I've only seen in books or on TV. You know, like on PBS with Jacques Cousteau. And oh my gosh, like Jacques Cousteau. You know, this is what I wanted to do ever since I was a kid. This was my Jacques Cousteau moment. I was living out one of my dreams. It was incredible. You know, and that was a perfect end to day two. So the last day of the course rolls around, but I'm not scared anymore, you know? Fear, gone. And we go for our last dive. The best. The best. I saw so much more than I did before. But the best part was getting this. That's right. I passed. Ha ha! So thank you, Cambodia, and the dive shop, for helping me find and conquer a new fear. It's the best feeling in the world, you know? And I say, let's keep it going. You know, do you have any fears that are maybe keeping you from living out some of your own dreams, or maybe just living life to the fullest? If that's the case, then let 2013 be the year that you conquer those fears. In fact, that's gonna be my slogan this year. 2013, the year to conquer fear. So let's do it. Let's conquer those fears. And if you like my videos, don't forget to subscribe. And since it's a new year, I got a new look for my blog, so check it out.